described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Mozzarella Media presents Violence in Schools. A teenage girl sits on her bed typing on a laptop.
I got a text from my friend Amy the other night.
She searches for her phone under a stuffed toy and some books.
She told me to check out our friend Mike's latest post.
She searches on the floor by her bed, then finds it under a couple of other books.
It seems he was mad at our English teacher for giving him a D on the essay.
She texts back, "Really?"
He said, and I quote, "Mr. B will live to regret this." I didn't think anything of it. Mike is a little overdramatic sometimes.
Title, Chapter 1, Emotional and Physical Threats. At school, Amy talks with a boy.
I started my civics homework, though.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Hey, Mike.
Mike barely looks at him as he heads upstairs.
What's wrong with him?
He was really angry yesterday. Mr. Blanchett gave him a D on his essay. He posted something like he was going to make Mr. B regret giving him a bad grade.
Later, a man sits at a desk writing in a classroom.
Please report to the office.
Mike stalks in and drops his backpack.
I can't believe you gave me a D. You just wanted to see me fail. I should mess you up.
He sweeps everything off the desk, grabs the backpack, and storms out past Amy and the boy.
So you saw that Mike posted a threat against Mr. Blanchard, and you didn't say anything?
Well, how was I supposed to know that he was going to do something? I thought he was just blowing off steam, you know? Should I have told someone?
Later, Amy's friend Alyssa picks up a tablet.
Should Amy have told somebody at the school? Should I? I mean, you see stuff online all the time. Kids fighting in the hallways or outside the school, students attacking teachers, people getting hurt. Just violent stuff. Why? I guess because people are stressed out, disappointed, or just mad about something. Some kids are teased, or I've seen girls and guys intentionally being excluded. And it can take a toll on you. They're just beat up emotionally. It's not physical violence, but it's still violence, and that can easily turn into physical violence. Threats are emotional violence, too. I've seen kids make threats face to face. Lots of times, threats are sent electronically.
Someone types a text, "Don't go to school tomorrow because I have something big planned."
Then I've seen people carry out their threats with physical violence. How do you respond to a threat?
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.